Well, good evening, Bellwood Quizzers. We're in sunny Blackpool. Of course we are, for week 64 of the quiz. It's Friday the 25th of June. Where did that go? At five quizzes for you this week, of course we have. At three general knowledge, with a K, we've got TV emoji shows. Oh, don't you love emojis? Yes, we do. And of course, one of the most favourite quizzes that we do, egg on your face. Why not? Why not indeed? Maxie and Joyce, you're driving home from work. You're allowed. You can play the quiz while driving. Why not? Anyway, before we start the quiz, we've got a couple of birthday mentions this week. We've got an actual quiz birthdayer tonight, Curtis Urban. 22 today. I remember my 22nd. No, I don't actually. I don't. Happy birthday. And there's also a birthday for Sunday. Shelley Martin Smart. At 48, I believe, but I wasn't allowed to say your name. Well, and your age together. So I haven't done. So happy birthday for both of you. Come on, let's sing along. Here we go, Bellwood Quizzers. Happy birthday, Curtis. Happy birthday, Shelley.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday indeed. Happy birthday, Karen. You are right. It is the weekend. Absolutely right. Let's crack on with quiz number one. Are we ready? 15 general knowledge questions. If it's anything like last week, they're going to be horrendous. But let's go. Here we go. Come on. Here we go then. Question number one. What term is given to a baby bat? So what's a baby bat called? Not a clue. But if you know, write it down. So what term is given to a baby bat? Question one. Question number two. The short-lived TV series El Dorado aired for the first time in which year? So what year did El Dorado first get onto our televisions? Karen, is that right? Curtis is going skydiving tomorrow. Must be mad. Send us a clip and we'll put it on the quiz. Crazy. Number three, what is the meaning of the Latin word thesaurus? So what's the meaning of the Latin word thesaurus? Do you think he's Thoris? I don't know, did he? Easy questions tonight, absolutely. Question four, the Valley of Sin. The Valley of Sin is found in which golf course? It's in the UK. I'll give that as a clue. A famous golf course in the UK. If you don't know, just leave it blank. And then when we say the answers, just write it in. There you go. The Valley of Sin. Question four. I think I live in the Valley of Sin. Here's number five. The Genesis is a luxury car made by which company? So the Genesis is a luxury car made by which company? Come on, Kev, you know your cars. Oh. Question number six. Which US singer had a 1980s hit with It's My Turn? Which US singer had a 1980 hit with It's My Turn? Ask Alexa really quick, go. And number seven, in which year did Tina Turner release the album Private Dancer? So in which year did Tina Turner release the album Private Dancer, Dancer for Money? Do what you want me to do, Shabba. At question number 8, what was it or what is it necessary to do to travel on a turnpike road? So what was it necessary to do to travel on a turnpike? In order to get on a turnpike, you have to do something. What do you have to do? Mandy Thompson from the other side of the pond, you'll do this every day. Y'all. Here's number 9. What type of creature is a turnstone? So what type of creature is a turnstone? Lynn, you'll know this. I'm sure you've got a book on turnstones. And question number 10. What was the name of the dog that accompanied Turner in the title of the 1989 film starring Tom Hanks? So Turner and what? What was the dog called? Do you remember that film? Turner and... Exactly. So what was that dog's name? Turner and what? It was that 1989 film with Tom Hanks. 11. Turn It On Again. I said it again. Turn It On Again. Was a 1999 greatest hits album for which band? Turn It On Again. I can feel it coming in the night. Anyway, number 12. What is the largest inland body of water in the world? So what's the largest inland body of water in the world? Tricky one. Is it somewhere in Russia, I think? Might be wrong with that. Question 12. Shelley, look on your map. Dead quick, go. Here's number 13. First made in 1972. Yeah, I was born. What was the Sinclair Executive? Oh, I've still got one in my pocket. What was the Sinclair Executive? What was it? Made in 1972. Google that one quick. And 14, White Scar Cave is in which national park? White Scar Cave is in which national park? Haven't a clue. Richard Dixon, I reckon you know that question. Stuart might have a guess at it as well. Here we go. Which luxury car brand has its headquarters at Gaydon in Warwickshire? So which luxury car brand has its headquarters at Gaydon in Warwickshire? Have a guess, a British luxury car manufacturer. If you know, write it down. Why not? So, how do you think we got on with that one? I think we did quite well, didn't we? Should we mark it? So, question 1, what term is given to a baby bat? Apparently that's called a pup. P-U-P? Didn't know that one. Number 2, the short-lived TV series El Dorado aired for the first time in which year? If you're 5 years either side of the answer, you can have a point. It was 1992. If you're 10 years, give yourself a point. Does it matter? Number 3, what is the meaning of the Latin word thesaurus? Do you think he saw us? No, is treasure. Apparently treasure. There you go. 4, the Valley of Sin is found on which golf course? It's the old course at St. Andrews. 5, the Genesis is a luxury car made by which company? Apparently that's Hyundai. 6, which singer had a 1980 hit with It's My Turn? Amanda Louise, you'll know that one. You're right, Diana Ross. Shout it at that telly. 7, in which year did Tina Turner release the album Private Dancer? Again, if you're 5 years either side, have a point. 1994. Number 8, what would you do to travel on a turnpike road? You'd pay a toll. Of course you would, Maddie. You pay a toll, you put a dime in there, or a quarter, or a cent, I don't know. Anyway, or a nickel. Number 9, what type of creature is a turnstone? It is a bird. And number 10, what was the name of the dog that accompanied Turner, in the title of the 1989 film starring Tom Hanks? It was Turner and Hooch. Turner and Hooch, of course it was. 11, Turn It On Again was a 1999 greatest hits album for which band? That was Genesis. And number 12, what's the largest inland body of water in the world? Anybody get this one right? Ooh, it was the Caspian Sea. Caspian Sea. 13, first made in 1972. What was the Sinclair Executive? Never seen one before. I'm going to Google it afterwards. It's a pocket calculator, but it was about that big. At 14, the White Scar Cave is in which national park? That's in the Yorkshire Dales. 15, which luxury car brand has its headquarters in Gaydon in Warwickshire? That's Aston Martin. Could have had a guess at that one, I reckon. Tot up your score out of 15. Let's see how you did. Come on. Zoe, they were not hard. It's just you're reading the wrong books during the week. Curtis is going skydiving tomorrow. What are you doing? Here we go, here comes some score. Janice with a 4, Karen with a 7. Shelly, birthday girl, 5. Mandy Thompson from the other side of the pond's got a 9. Kev got a 9, oh, well cheated. Well done. Oh, really? Oh, Julian Avril. Oh, that's not a good start from the Welsh lovelies. Richard, a lower 8. Oh, well done, Richard, with an 8. It's all right. Dad, usual 4. Andy, 6 out of 15. I know the feeling. I know the feeling. It's always a long week at Bellwood Towers. 8 for Stuart. That's a good score. Jane and John. Terrible night. It's actually a very good night, Jane and John. Curtis, 6. Good score. Happy birthday, boy. Double it. You get 14. Plus 2. Bob, starting on a high on an 8. Absolutely. Judith, 5. Not to worry, Judith. Guy with a 7. Well done, Guy. And Amanda Louise, double figures with a 10. Well done. Well, what can I say? What can I say? No, there were some tricky ones. Anyway, let's ramp it up a gear. I think we should. We're going to do an emoji quiz now. Everybody loves an emoji. 15 questions on TV shows. And they're emojis. So you need to look at them closely and think TV show. All British TV shows, as far as I'm aware. I can't remember. I did it so long ago. Are we ready? Let's go with TV emojis. Here we go. Question number one. So what's the TV show? Any ideas on that one? Do you want me to give you a clue for the first one? No, I'm not going to. So what is that lady's profession? Yeah, got that. And then what's the TV show? Simple, isn't it? So simple. Here's number two. What do we say when we clink them together? Right, no more clues now. That's it. I'm going for a drink. See you in two. Now, I have no idea on this one, but think of the compass and look at the direction. Well, look at the letter and that gives you the direction of the compass, I'll say that. Anybody get that one from that? Like me in the morning when the kids get up. The music's 80s funky enough for you, Guy. Here's number 5. Number 6. Any idea what that one is? really famous TV show, that one. Number 7. Never watched an episode of this. But what is that? And that will give you the answer to the show. Dead easy. We're halfway through already, Bellwood Quizzers, of Quiz 2, TV emojis. Take 2 bottles into the shower. Why? You only need to take 1. Pantene, wash and go. Number 8. We should do voiceovers for the advert, shouldn't we? What is that? Remember TV shows? What's the name of that TV show? Might be a Netflix one, that, I think. Number 9, an easy one, I think that. Although mum and dad, you won't have a clue. And number 10, name the TV show. I can't even think that myself. What is that one? I don't know, I've forgotten. Number 11 was easy. Number 12, anybody ideas on that one? If you do, write it down. You are the weakest link.
Goodbye.
What's happened to her face? Name the TV show. Number 14, an easy one that, I think. Say what you see and write it down. One more to go. Love the emoji round. Zoe, are you on the Prosecco this week or cocktails? Dirty beer. So read it as you would see that, and that's the name of the TV show. Question 15, that's your last one of the TV emojis. So, how did we get on there? It wasn't too bad, was it? Okay. Should we mark the TV emoji show? Let's do it. Number 1 was Doctor Who. Yeah, okay. Easy, wasn't it? Number 2 was Cheers. 3, I don't know if anybody got that. I've never heard of it, but I'm sure it's a TV show. Westworld? Yeah, I've never seen it. 4 was Dead Men Walking. 5, Blackadder. Number 6, anybody get that with the jokers and the horses? Only Fools and Horses. Of course it was. Ugh. Number 7 was The Crown. 8, House of Cards. 9, of course, was Cold Feet. 10, did anybody get number 10 right? Luther. Lou and Fur. Luther. Okay. 11, Gogglebox. 12 was Frozen Planet. 13 was Countdown. With Anne Robinson coming on, what on earth has happened to her? Not good, not good. She must have been to Bellwood plastic surgery. At 14, One Foot in the Grave. And number 15, it was spelt out for you. It was that easy. Would I lie to you? Would I? Anyway, tot up your score out of 15. I think we should get some high marks on this round. Fingers crossed. Come on, Julie. Come on, Avril. Karen and Tim, I'm hoping things, good scores from you. Richard Dixon has popped a 13 into the bag. Well done, Richard. Oh, I do like it when quizzes work like that. Janice with an 11. That is a good score. And Thompson, can we have Walking Dead instead? Of course you can. Absolutely, Mandy. Why not? Kathy with a 14. Luther got us. I know it was a tricky one, wasn't it? That, but good score, Kathy. 14 is fantastic. Stuart didn't get Luther as well. Yeah, tricky one. But you know it now. You know for next time. Karen with 10. Any help from Tim tonight or flying solo? Kev, 10. Well done. Well done. Little help from Lynn, I reckon, there. Julian Avril. Oh, you are doing well. You're doing Wales proud. You're doing Wales proud. 10 out of 15. Curtis, happy birthday. Got a 12. Well done. Edith got most of those. Good. Well done, man. Guy, 16. Smashed it. Well done. 50% improvement, 9. Well done, Andy. It's a good score. Judith got a 9 as well, so she's happy with herself. We got 10 out of 15. Think I lost my audio. Right, okay. Well, it was a picture round. Cheating. Devils, good lord. Much better. Well done, Bob and Sue. It bumps up the scores, doesn't it? Doubled up to 8, Dad. Well done. To the side of pond, Mandy with a 14. But Shit's Creek and Luther. Everybody's been up Shit Creek at some point. Jane and John, 14. Good score. Gary, you're flying solo tonight. You deserve a glass of wine. You mean 9. Guy, you were just trying to pull the wool over our eyes there, weren't you? Hey, trying to get some sneaky points, you naughty boy. So let's have a quick 60-second break and then we'll come back and we'll start quiz number 3 because I know you can't wait. Come on, back in 60 clicks. Toodaloo. £2 for a donkey ride, Kev. £2 for a donkey ride. We'd look where we are now. Look at that. Look at the big one. Oof, there it is, just there. It's very quiet at Blackpool at the moment. Very quiet. Nobody's wearing any masks. All eating donuts and chips. Lovely. Let's crack on to quiz number 3. 15 more questions. Are we ready, Bellwood Quizzes? I'm not going to say too much about this because the questions have been horrendous so far. Here we go. Quiz number 3 to get your brain bamboozled. Some more general knowledge. Here we go. Question number 1. Chantelle Horton was the first non-celebrity to win which reality TV series? Chantelle Horton. Anybody remember that? Was the first non-celebrity to win which reality TV series? A good few years ago now. Are they watching me? Who's watching me? Who? Number 2. Ivan the Terrible served as the Grand Prince of which city? So Ivan the Terrible served as the Grand Prince of which city? Question number 2, done. Nice bit of jazz for you. At number 3, in which decade did Richard Branson found Virgin Atlantic? So in which decade did Richard Branson found Virgin Atlantic? Question 3. Sounds like Kev on his organ. Here's number 4. Which member of Queen wrote Don't Stop Me Now? So which member of Queen wrote Don't Stop Me Now? It's a famous person. Have a guess. Come on, Julie. Who did it? Who wrote it? Don't stop me now. Number five, which rapper featured on Katy Perry's 2010 hit, California Girls? So which rapper featured on Katy Perry's 2010 single, California Girls? So who's the rapper that was on that song, California Girls 2010? Blimey. Number six, Hit That Perfect Beat was a 1985 hit for which group? Would you like me to sing it? Hit that perfect beat, boy. Hit that perfect beat. There you go. That's as much as I'm going to give you. Beautiful. An angelic voice came over the airwaves then. So who had a hit in 1985? What was the group's name? Number seven. What type of animal is a quoll? Simple as that. What type of animal is a quoll? Q-U-O-L-L. And question number eight, what is the airport code for Beijing International Airport? So what's the airport code? It's three letters for Beijing International. Have a guess if you don't know. If you don't know, Google it really quick. So what's the airport code for Beijing International? Number nine, which US state is nicknamed the Land of the Midnight Sun? So which US state is nicknamed the Land of the Midnight Sun? Sounds like a movie. Did you ever watch Deadliest Catch? Question number 10, which is the seventh book of the Old Testament? So which is the seventh book of the Old Testament? Google it quick if you don't know. And question 11. What type of creature is a Swedish blue? It's not cheese. So what type of creature is a Swedish blue? Come on, Judith. You know the answer to this one. Had a few Swedish blues in your garden. Number 12, which well-known children's artist designed the Blue Peter logo? So which well-known children's artist designed the Blue Peter logo? Must have been in about the 80s, was it? Could have been the 70s, I don't know. But a well-known children's artist, who was it? 13. In which decade did Iron Maiden release the album The Number of the Beast? So in which decade did Iron Maiden release the album The Number of the Beast? Come on down. What's your number? 0898 44 44 42. At question 14. How is the Savage Mountain more widely known? So how is the Savage Mountain more widely known? So it's the mountain, big massive mountain, but what's it actually known as? They call it the Savage Mountain, but what's its real name? Number 15, Dulles Airport serves which US city? Mandy from the other side of the pond is laughing at this question. So Dulles International, does that help you? Airport serves which US city? Last one. Done. Oh, back there now. Shall we move quick? Let's move. Oh, there we are. We're on the beach. That's better, isn't it? It's a bit warmer at the beach. Let's mark quiz number three, then we can go and have a laugh and a lie down. So question one, Chantel Horton was the first non-celebrity to win which reality TV series? That was Celebrity Big Brother. Number two, Ivan the Terrible served as the Grand Prince of which city? That was Moscow. Good guess on that one. Three, in which decade did Richard Branson found Virgin Atlantic? It was the 1980s. It was 1984. Number four, which member of Queen wrote Don't Stop Me Now? Could have had a guess. Freddie Mercury, believe it or not. There you go. At five, the rapper featured on Katy Perry's 2010 single Californian Girls was Snoop Dogg. Number six, Hit That Perfect Beat. I'm not going to sing it this time. It was a 1985 hit for which group? That was Bronski Beat. And number seven, what type of animal is a quoll? That's a marsupial. Eight, what's the airport code for Beijing International? P-E-K, I think it's for Peking, isn't it? P-E-K, Papa Echo Kilo. If you want your phonetics, there you go. Number nine, which US state is nicknamed the Land of the Midnight Sun? And that's Alaska. Of course it is, because it doesn't go dark in the summer. Ten, which is the seventh book of the Old Testament? Apparently that's Judges. 11, what type of creature is a Swedish blue? Oh, it's a duck. Quack, believe it or not. 12, which well-known children's artist designed the Blue Peter logo? Anybody get that? That was Tony Hart. 13, in which decade did Iron Maiden release the album The Number of the Beast? It was the 1980s. It was 1982. 14, how is the Savage Mountain more widely known? It's known as K2. And number 15, Dulles Airport serves which US city? That's Washington. They weren't too bad, were they? I don't know. Anyway, tot up your score out of 15. Don't be embarrassed if there's just got one, Zoe. Just pop it down, it's all right. So some scores coming through. Shelley with a 6. And the questions have to get tougher, I'm afraid, because we've used up all the children's quiz questions. 9 from Mandy from t'other side of the pond. How's the weather over there? Here we go, look, more scores coming through. Dreadful 5, Andy. Don't worry about it. Janice with a 4. Just have a drink in the break, you'll be fine. Curtis, good score with a 9, well done. Kev, 7, yes, Karen, 7. So you don't need Tim. Oh, really? Oh. Yeah, have you had an internet cut with your online friends? 13, Edith, not much help. Well, don't worry about it. Just give me some more Calpol. Jane and John with a 10, well done. Dad back to normal too. Kathy with a 10, good score, Kathy. Guy, it's a good 6. Richard Dixon, 9. Stuart with a 10, well done. Bob with an 11, good score, Bob. Judith, 12, fabulous, well done. So let's go for a quick break. We'll see you back in a couple of minutes. Two more to go. We've got another general knowledge. And the best quiz of all time, Egg on Your Face. See you in a couple of minutes, Bellwood Quizzes. Toodaloo. Hello, 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 and welcome back to the second part of this week's Bellwood Quiz. Yes, week 64. Where's it going to end? We might be live from Ibiza next week, who knows? Yeah, right. Should we crack on with quiz number four? I think we should. I'll give you a clue. I'll give you question one. I've just got the answer there. I can just see it now. It's got three answers to it. I'll give you red and green. You just need to find out one more. You'll know what I mean. Come on. So I've given you red and green as the answers. So which three colours are featured on the Hungarian flag? So you've got red and green. What's the other colour on the Hungarian flag? Gosh, I'm kind. I'm so kind tonight. Everybody will at least hopefully get one on this round. Here's number two. What is the capital of the US state of Florida? So what's the capital of the US state of Florida? Question number two. It's not what you think it is. And question three, GBG. GBG is the international car registration letter for which or from which island? So GBG is the international car registration letter for which island? Do we know that one? Number four, in which decade were the hand signals dropped from the driving test? So in which decade were the hand signals dropped from the driving test? Have a guess at that one. Here's number five already. In relation to railways. Oh, here you are, Joan and Eric. In relation to railways, what is the English equivalent of a caboose? So in relation to railways, what's the English equivalent of a caboose? So what's the English equivalent of a caboose? Dead easy. Number six, which part of the body would be affected by myalgia? So which part of the body could be or would be affected by myalgia? Question six. Here's number seven. Arthur Stanley Jefferson was the real name of which comedian? Arthur Stanley Jefferson was the real name of which comedian? Good few years ago, this one. It's not a recent comedian. It was a double act, if that helps you. And question number eight. Which fictional character lives under the name of Mr. Sanders? So which fictional character lives under the name of Mr. Sanders? Anybody know that one? A fictional character, Mr. Sanders. Question eight. Here's number nine. What's the alternative name for the UK's Western Isles? Up in Scotland, isn't it, I think? So what's the alternative name for the UK's Western Isles? Question 10. New Holland was the historical European name given to which country? So New Holland, was the historical European name given to which country? Did I give you a clue? Oh, you naughty boy. At 11, which US state is nicknamed the Golden State? Katy Perry sang about it before. Which US state is nicknamed the Golden State? At question 12, Richie and Eddie were the main characters in which London-based sitcom of the early 90s? Richie and Eddie, or Eddie and Richie, were the main characters of which London-based sitcom in the early 1990s? Not giving any more clues on that one. 13. In what decade did Open All Hours first air on TV? So in what decade did Open All Hours first air on TV? And question 14, Polpetta. Polpetta is the Italian for which food? Polpetta. So what type of Italian food is polpetta? Question 14. It's not pasta, I'll give you that one. And number 15, what is the meaning of the French cookery term sous vide? So what's the meaning of the French cookery term sous vide? So what do they do when they sous vide food? How do they cook it? Just tell me in English. Come on, Julie. You sous vide all the time. So, there we go. Look where we are now. Oh, look, tower. Oh, look, the tower at the top. Top at tower. Oh, there it is. Anyway, quiz four. I gave you two answers. We've only got one to find here. Which three colours are featured on the Hungarian flag? You've got red, green, and white. Number two, what's the capital of the US state of Florida? Anybody get this? It's Tallahassee. Tallahassee. But everybody puts somewhere else. Never heard of Tallahassee. But there we go. Three, GBG is the international car registration letters for which island? And that's Guernsey. GB? G? Guernsey? Okay. Four, in which decade were hand signals dropped from the driving test? It was in the 1970s. It's 1975, to be precise. Number five, in relation to railways, what is the English equivalent of a caboose? And apparently that's the guard's van. There you go. If they still ever exist, I don't know. Number six, which part of the body would be affected by myalgia? That's your muscles. Seven, Arthur Stanley Jefferson was the real name of which comedian? That's Stan Laurel. Number eight, which fictional character lives under the name of Mr. Sanders? Anybody get that? It's Winnie the Pooh. Nine, what's the alternative name for the UK's Western Isles? That's the Outer Hebrides. Number 10, New Holland was the historical European name given to which country? And that was Australia. There you go. Didn't know that, did you? You do now. 11, which US state is nicknamed the Golden State? That's California. 12, I've got an itchy nose. I think I'm going to sneeze. It's gone. 12, Richie and Eddie were the main characters in which London-based sitcom in the early 90s? That was Bottom. 13, in what decade did Open All Hours first air on TV? It was in the 1970s, 1976. 14, Polpetta is the Italian for which food? That's meatballs. And number 15, what's the meaning of the French cookery term sous vide? That's under a vacuum. Simple as that. Tot up your score out of 15. Don't be shy. Let's see how we got. Mandy smashed it with a 30. Well done, Amanda. Well done. 13. Good bit of knowledge there in your brain at your age. Mandy from t'other side of the pond with a 9. Janice, Karen with a 7. Where are that? Where's that gone? There we go. Janice with a 6. Apologies, it all messed up there. Somebody else got an 8. Well done. Stuart with a 9. Kathy, 10. Richard Dixon, 7. Julian Avril, 11. Wowzers. Avril must be on fire tonight. Shelley, 5, not going very well tonight. Just have a drink, Shell. Nice cup of tea. guy with a 7, Karen with an 11. Oh, Andy, have a drink. Forget about it, it's Friday. Jane and John with 11. That is a very good score, Jane and John. Be proud of that. Kev. Sure you've not got that the right way around. Well done, Kev, with a 10. Mum and Dad are number 8. Hope you got your baboose right. Bob and Sue, 10. Well done. Judith, 12. That's a good score, Judith. Well done. Curtis, be happy with a 7. I would. Oh, Jane's just come back. Oops, only at... Oh, yes. Cheating. Blinking egg. So, here we go. The best quiz of the night coming up. Egg on your face. Love this one. Not splatted eggs. These are eggs in shells this week for a change. You're going to see 15 pictures of famous people that have got egg on their face. Simple. You just need to tell me who those people are. Are you ready, Bellwood Quizzes? Let's get cracking. No pun intended. Smashing. There we go. So, question number one. Who's got egg on their face? Just write down the name of the person. Simple as cheese. Here's number two. Is that a boy or a girl? I don't know. But somebody's got eggs on their face. Who is that? Number three. I think that's Tony from across the road. But who's that person with egg on their face? Anybody remember that? Name of the person or the character, doesn't matter. There is a person under there, under the eggs. It's the big egg at the back. But what's that person's name? And no, Julie, we can't have the little one from Austin Powers. Number five, who's that dirty rat? Bet there's a few eggs thrown at him at the moment, but what's his name? Question five, egg on your face. Here's number six. These are too easy tonight. What's going on with these? Seven. Is that tricky? Through the gap in the eggs. That's where you're looking. Mum and Dad, put the kettle on, don't worry. But who is that? Who's that famous person? Number seven. Number eight. She's been splatted with eggs. But what's her name? Question number eight. Write it down, Bellwood Quizzars. Question number nine, an easy one thrown in there. What's the name of that person? You'd probably whip up an omelette. Number 10. Do I give you a clue? No, it's an easy one, that isn't it? It's pointless giving you a clue. Was that a clue? Oh. It wasn't a clue at all, was it? No. Number 11. Who's the famous person? We've got to put some easy ones in, haven't we, to give you some points. couple of tricky ones coming up, I think. But number 11, that's quite an easy one. Number 12. I think that's an easy one as well. Just write down the names. Number 13, is that a tricky one for you? If it isn't, write it down. If it is, have a guess. It's just for fun, it's Friday. Any idea who that person is? I haven't a clue. I thought it was Vanessa Phelps for a minute, but it isn't. She's got egg on her face, but what's her name? Here we go, the last one of egg on your face. These are too easy. What's the name of that fluffy egg? Write it down, Bellwood Quizzes, the last question of this week's quiz. Oh, and the eggs have been smashed everywhere. Anyway, let's mark the quiz because I just need to go on the penny arcades in a minute. Egg on your face. Number one was Kat Deely. Two was Miley Cyrus. Number three was Sacha Baron Cohen or Ali G in it. I won't carry on with that one. Number four was Vern Troyer. Five, Ryan Giggs. I'm going to sneeze. Excuse me for a second. There we go. Nobody would ever know. Edit that out. Cut it out. Five was Ryan Giggs. Six, Tom Hanks. Number seven, peeking through was Ed Sheeran. Number eight was Beyonce Knowles. Nine, make an omelette out of it, Jamie. Jamie Oliver. Number 10 was Ben Shepherd. I know it's not pointless. It's tipping point. I was just throwing you off the scent. 11, an easy one there, I think, Tom Cruise. 12 was Matthew Perry. 13, Leonardo DiCaprio. 14, apparently, is Rebel Wilson. Never heard of her, don't know. And number 15 is Danny DeVito. So there you go. Tot your score up out of 15 and then your grand total out of 75 points. Let's see how you did this week on week 64. Come on. Here we go. I reckon some good scores coming through. Mandy has popped her information through the information superhighway across the Atlantic, underneath, through a cable, and it's come up with 14. Well done, Mandy. Janice with a 6. Get in the net, Richard. Well done with a 15. That's brilliant. Stuart smashed it as well with a 15. Well done. Avril and Julie with an 8. Well done. You've done well. You've done us proud. The Sprats with a 13. Ooh, good scores from the Sprats. Well done. Here we go, some more scores coming through. So Richard, that gives you a total of 53. Dad, coffee ready? Right, 15, one. Okay, well, don't worry, Dad, it's fine. You've had fun, it's the main thing. Kevin, 11, well done. Kathy, 14, good score. Avril, you're welcome. Karen, 14, it gives you a 49, you're welcome. Jane and John, 11 on that one. I think you should have quite a good score this week, Jane and John. Curtis, 15 out of 15, 50. Smashed it. Well done, Curtis. Have a super day tomorrow skydiving. Don't forget to breathe. Mandy, 55. Gives you a good score from Thompson's. Well done. 56, Stuart. Oh, it's creeping up. Andy, you're welcome. 10 out of 10 for enjoying. Well, we've got to have a laugh, haven't we, in these strange times. Judith, it gives you an 8, it gives you a 46. You're welcome for another quiz down. 7 for Guy, 36 total. Shabba, absolutely. Kathy, 55 total. Well done, Kathy. I think you're flying high there. 39 for Shell. Shabba-tastic. A miserable 31. Must do better. Janice, don't worry about it. It's all done now. Nobody will remember it. Just have a nice drink and enjoy the weekend. doesn't matter, honestly. See you in the sky tomorrow, Curtis. Oh, well, if you're over Bellwood Towers, give us a wave. Bob, 9 on that one, because you're 52 total. Well done. Jane, you're welcome. We'll hopefully see you next week for some more crazy quiz questions. So that's it for week 64. It's ridiculous. I'm just at the top of the tower. I'm on the glass bit. It's not cracked yet. I have a couple more donuts and it might do. So I will stay up here. I'll watch the sun set. The beautiful, beautiful Blackpool as it is. We will see you next week for quiz 65. Do take care of yourself wherever you end up, even if it's the Balearics. Send me a postcard. We'll see you next week. Shabba. You're welcome, Mama Julie. See you soon. Toodaloo. Shabba.